These researchers claim they can make old brains young again. They were successful on mice, and they showed that their approach also works using human cells. Hello and welcome. This is 2-Minute Bioengineering with Julius Eckert. When we get old, we get a lot of age-related diseases. For the brain, we usually get cognitive decline and Alzheimer. These scientists have now figured out that the fault is with our own bodies. The bad guys are the macrophage cells. Their job is to protect us, but with age, they turn evil and attack us. Luckily, the scientists also found a way to get the macrophage cells back into good shape and on the right track to do their job of serving and protecting us. Macrophage cells are normally the body's all-round talents for keeping you healthy. They eat all the dead cells and grow stuff like misfolded proteins, which otherwise cause nasty neurodegeneration like Alzheimer. Macrophages also cause inflammation to annihilate pathogens that thought they can trespass on our healthy bodies. With age, however, we see a lot of malformed macrophages. Instead of eating bad proteins to protect us from Alzheimer, they instead cause inflammation in random places without good cause. Inflammation is very destructive and usually only used in rare cases to protect the body from pathogens. But these malformed macrophages cause inflammation all over the place, destroying a lot of healthy tissue. And if you destroy healthy tissue in the brain, it ain't going to work that good for long. Luckily, the researchers figured out why so many macrophages are malformed. It's basically caused by too many molecules called PGE2. They connect to macrophages on a receptor called EP2, and that pathway causes the storage of glucose, which is bad because stored glucose cannot be used directly by the cell. So the cell will not have enough glucose for cell respiration. The macrophage cells are basically starved of energy, which affects many processes in the cell, resulting in the evil malformed macrophages we see destroying our brain. So the researchers figured they just need to stop the PGE2 connecting to the EP2 receptors, and everything should be fine. When they put in a substance to block the EP2 receptor, they actually observed the return of well-formed macrophages. They checked the brain chemistry, where many substances return to useful levels. And instead of being happy about just a world of microorganisms being well again, they wanted to know if it actually makes brains young again. When they tested it on mice, they used the Barnes maze, a well-established test to measure spatial learning and memory. And as you can see, the normally aged mice with a broken brain needed quite a while to find the escape hole, while the old mice with their rejuvenated brains find the hole pretty quickly, a performance comparable to young mice. And since bad brains and broken brains are a horrible burden on so many individuals and families, we can only hope this research will result in a drug for humans as soon as possible. The researchers already confirmed that all the mechanisms are working with human cells, but they still have to put it through clinical trials to make sure it's not toxic for humans. And since the scientists have not observed any toxicity with mice, we can be cautiously hopeful. Thank you for watching. This was 2-Minute Bioengineering with Julius Eckert.